You got this. Come on.
Okay.
You got this.
This video that I'm about to post is something which is very, very scary and nerve-wracking, and I'm so incredibly nervous to put this video out there. I'm so incredibly nervous even sitting in front of this camera right now. I've taken a break from social media for the last week, and yeah, I feel like even sitting in front of this camera, I'm really struggling. But I wanted to put this video out there because I want to show the depths and the darkness that hate and online trolling and abuse can cause to people. And this last week that I've filmed has been my reality. I have not held back from anything, and I wanted to show you that. Some of these clips that you're going to see are really hard to watch, but I wanted to show you that words create an effect, and words destroy people. And they're not just words. They have a reaction. Every action creates a reaction, and the video that you're about to see is completely raw, completely uncut, and the most honest video I could ever put out there to show you the effect of hate, the effect that it's had on me. And this isn't about me, this video. This isn't for me. This is for other people who are going through this, or other people who have gone through this. And I feel like my best thing at the moment I can be is completely honest and raw and open with you guys and share this journey. I know that so many people are going through so many different things, so much harder than this, but I just wanted to be honest with you because this has been my reality for the last week. I know I'm not going to change the world, but if I could change one person watching this, it would mean so much. If I could just open someone's eyes to how low hate and online abuse can destroy you, how it can absolutely break you as a person, and it can take you to darkness and depths you didn't even think were possible. So thank you for all of your love and all of your support. I'm so incredibly nervous to post this video because I really don't... Watching it back has been really hard, so putting it out there, just please be kind, and if you don't have anything nice to say, just don't say it. Waste your energy on something that is worth wasting your energy on. Yeah, so just gonna play the video. I hope it's okay. And did I say thank you for every single... Yeah, I think I said thank you. Thank you for everyone that's been so lovely to me. Even if you don't know who I am and you've just sent me love, it honestly means the absolute world. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. I think this ring light is just terrible. Is it the ring light? No, it's probably me. Is it the ring light? Because it just looks awful. Is it too bright? Oh, it's just me and my face. Okay. So, I'm not going to do much with my eyes today because... wait, let's do that again. So I'm going to start with my foundation because I'm not going to do much with my eyes today because obviously you know me, I'm rubbish at eye makeup. I can't say that. So I'm going to do... I don't even know what I'm saying. So I'm going to put my foundation on first because I'm not going to do much with my eyes because... I don't know what I'm saying. Oh my god. Okay, cut that all out. So I'm going to go in with my foundation first because my eye makeup isn't going to be very heavy because heavy makeup looks awful on me right now. I'll just stop. Okay. Just cut all that out. So I'm going to go in with my foundation first. So I'm going to take the Laura Mercier Flawless Lucent... I don't know what I'm saying. Laura Mercier Flawless Radiance Perfecting Foundation. So I'm just going to pop a bit on there. Should have probably put it on the back of my hand, but who cares? I'm just gonna pop that on my face. I really like this one. Doesn't match my skin color. Doesn't match my skin color, does it? Nope. Looks horrendous. I try and blend it out. That's orange, isn't it? completely lost it. I don't know. Okay. Now I'm starting again. Taking that off, doing new foundation. I'm mainly looking in the viewfinder, so I don't actually have to really look in the mirror. Because you can't really see much from the viewfinder. Is that all off? Right. Okay. So I'm going to take my foundation, which is the Maybelline Fit Me Matte. I literally feel so insecure doing this. So I'm going to take the Maybelline Fit Me. I'm going to take the Maybelline Fit Me Poreless 220. Normal to oily skin, but definitely not normal to oily because I've got dry skin and it doesn't look, I don't know what I'm saying. Okay, so I'm just gonna blend that with a beauty blender. It's still just as dark. It looks awful. Everyone is gonna take the mic. I can't, that is so orange, isn't it? I can't, it just looks horrendous. I could blend it down to my neck. So I'm just going to keep blending this. I love this foundation. I think it's amazing. I don't know if this is the same colour, which it is. Normally I have a little bit more colour to my skin. So this is normally my colour, but not at the moment. Everyone else has been sunbathing, but I've got nowhere to sunbathe. So that looks awful. I look so horrendous. Like, looking in the viewfinder, I literally look so ugly. I can't do this. I actually can't do this. I actually can't. It's making me feel so insecure and so on edge. I literally can't do it. I'm so angry that I'm allowing this to get to me. Honestly, looking in that viewfinder, I could literally pick out 100 things that's wrong with me. Spence, I can't do this. I cannot film. I cannot film. I can't be myself anymore. I feel so anxious right now. I feel so anxious. My stomach feels like it's like sucking in, like full of anxiety. You know when it's like all in your stomach? Can't. I'm flipping that viewfinder down because I physically cannot look at that. I don't know how to get back to being myself. I don't know how to be me again. Like, I don't know how to be like the same as, like, I don't know. I've lost my spark. Like, I've lost my spark. And I feel like that was the best part about me. Like, the part where I'm just a bit quirky and funny and eccentric and I don't know how to be that person anymore. I'm switching this off because I can't. I'm literally on the brink of anxiety. I can't. I need some water, please, baby.
What?
Oh.
You alright?
I can't breathe, Spence. I know I can.
It's alright.
I'm hot, I'm hot.
I'm even when the window's open. So, take that. Are you alright?
Yeah. You okay?
Just please, calm me. I've barely got my top off.
Relax, sorry. Feels so tight here, you know?
Yeah, just breathe in and out. In and out. That's it. You're right. Just think of the sea. Just think of the sea and the waves. It's all right.
Oh God.
It's all right.
My throat hurts now.
It's all right. Remember, if you're talking, you can breathe. It's all right. Got this. That's it. Just relax.
I feel like the room's like caving in. No,
that's just me. Alright. Just relax. Really good. Just wanna have a lie down.
Yeah.
Alright. Just sit on that. That's it.
I don't wanna go anywhere today.
You don't have to. It's alright.
Thank you.
Just have a sleep. You're alright.
Turn it off now, baby, please.
Okay.
So it's a new day and I sort of just wanted to document this because I feel so pathetic and stupid, but I feel like I've gone completely backwards to when I was like 16. I was really insecure and I was so silly and thought everyone was staring at me and thought I was really unattractive. And I'm gonna be honest, like, these sunglasses, I wish they could cover my whole face. Like, I'm a bit on edge with Spencer and just feeling a bit on edge in general. Like, going anywhere at the moment, even to get food, I feel like everyone's looking at me. Everyone can see that I'm insecure, so then they're going to be looking at me, and no one's probably even looking at me. But I'm a bit annoyed at myself that I've allowed this to happen, and I'm annoyed that I overcame so many insecurities, and I'm annoyed that I'm going through this at the moment, if you know what I mean. Like, I don't need to wear sunglasses, but Spencer was like, take them off, you look beautiful. But just, I don't know, I don't really feel like I can at the moment, and I know that sounds stupid, but I just feel like these are like making me feel like I've got a barrier, and I don't know, and then no one will make eye contact with me, and then I don't have to feel insecure, you know what I mean? I can't sleep. Haven't slept properly in like 2 weeks properly. Oh, my stomach is playing up. Oh God, I'm in so much pain. When I get anxiety and when I get stressed, my stomach just goes absolutely awful. I think my condition, my stomach condition, just thrives on stress. Oh my God, I'm so embarrassed, I'm so sorry. Oh my God. What time is it? Lovely. 4:56 in the morning. I literally can't sleep at the moment. My worry, my stress, my anxiety, my stomach is just playing up. I feel ill all the time. I have constant gas, pain. My colon is throbbing. I don't want to wake Spence up. He needs to sleep. One of us has to have some energy tomorrow. Ow. Oh my God. Oh my God, it's literally like throbbing. It just makes me feel worse because tomorrow I know I need energy, but I can't sleep because I feel so ill and I'm so stressed. Ow. Oh my God, it's so bloated. I got so much acid coming up at the moment as well. It's horrible. It's just sitting on my throat. I just can't handle stress or anxiety or anything like that because my stomach just, I'll make myself so ill. I've been so unwell. Spencer's just seen my stomach get so much worse. It's every night. I have like 3 hours sleep and then I wake up and just feel like a zombie. I feel even more stressed and more anxious. It's just a really bad, ow. Ah, sorry. Oh my God. Okay, I'm gonna leave you somewhere. I'll leave you there. Oh God, oh my 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 God. I put a bit of fake tan on to try and make myself look a bit better. It's all over my top probably. Oh, it is, oh God. Sorry, I've moved down here because I'm trying to get some wind up. In the morning, I wake up sometimes with sick on my stomach. Sometimes I wake up in the morning with bile and sick all over my top, and it must have been in the night, and then I get worried because I think, oh God, my stomach has stretched so much that I feel like it can't stretch any further, if you know what I mean, like it's that bloated. And I know this is all stress, but I can't do anything about it at the moment because my head is in such a negative space, and I know I should be thinking about my mental health because that would help my stomach, but I can't stop these anxious thoughts, and the more anxious I get, the worse my stomach gets. Like my stomach, I can't take this pain. I actually can't take this pain. I'm gonna have to go wake Spence up. I'm sorry. I actually can't. Ow, ow. I feel like my neck looks fat. Or is it because this? With the headband or no headband? No, that is awful. Okay. Hello, honeys! Hello, honeys! So annoying. Hello, honeys! So loud. That was loud. Hello, honeys! That's annoying me. That looks awful. I should straighten it. Oh, you're annoying me. I can't do it. I can't even do my own intro. Oh. Hello, honeys. I can't. I look like I'm gonna cry. Should I take this off? Better? Is it better? Aww. I should put my makeup on, shouldn't I? Okay. My voice doesn't sound the same. Oh my God. I can't do it. Every time I sit down, all I can see and hear in my head is insecurities. All I can see is everything that people say about me. I can't even speak without thinking my intonation's funny. I sound stupid. I sound annoying. I am annoying. Should I be saying hello, honeys? I've been saying hello, honeys since I started my channel. Why would I change it now? My throat's dry. My hands feel clammy. My stomach feels like I've got anxiety. I feel like I've got anxiety in my throat. I can't keep going like this, because I won't ever. I don't feel secure enough to put mascara on. I don't feel secure enough to put full face of makeup on because I feel like I look stupid or I look ugly, and my brows look horrendous. My lips are too overlined. My skin hasn't got any colour on it. I look and feel horrendous. Horrendous. Every single day, I think I have 1 minute of positivity where I feel like, okay, I don't know how I'm gonna get back to being myself. I feel numb and weird and negative and shit. Excuse my language. Can't be bothered, sorry. I can't. Oh god. Oh. Fuck, I can't breathe. Oh, Spencer's gone to the car. I feel like I need him and he's not here. I can't breathe, I can't breathe. It's so small. I feel like it's so small. I feel like it's caving in on me. Oh god. He's only gone to the car. I don't even want to be filming this, but I feel like I need to show people. This is happening constantly. I can't breathe. It's on my throat. It's on here. Oh, Spencer, please come back. I can't breathe. I know I can breathe. Oh god, it feels like this room is so small. It feels like this room is literally... so close to me. I can't. Oh my god, please Spencer, just come back, please. What's Spencer gonna do? I don't know. Oh my god, I don't know what to do. Oh god, I feel so... My back. Why does it feel like everything hurts in my body? But it doesn't. It doesn't hurt. Oh my god. I can't take this anymore. I can't keep doing this. I can't keep going through this all the time. I need some water. I'm meant to be having a break from social media because I'm not uploading, I'm not going on or anything like that. And there you go. I go on Instagram and there's already hate. And I feel like I have to be on top of it, because if I'm not on top of it and I don't keep deleting the hate or reporting these people and keep getting their accounts, you know, deleted, then I feel like the hate's just gonna sit there, and then the hate is going to get looked at, and then people are going to see how much hate I get, and that's why I need to delete it. But it's becoming consuming. But Spencer says he's going to have to take my phone off me, because if I'm not on my phone, I'm going on the YouTube video looking for hate. I'm looking at all the comments that need to be reviewed, and I'm thinking, like, this person looks like a really beautiful, pretty girl, and she's giving me hate. And like, I'm going through my DMs, and they're such amazing ones, but I'm looking for hate. It's honestly becoming so suffocating and consuming, and I'm being pathetic, and I know it's my own fault, but this is what it's doing to me. Like, if they don't have a photo on the DM, I think, oh my god, it's gonna be hate. But then sometimes they have photos, and sometimes they have families, and they're grown adults, grown women, grown men. The amount of men that have been doing it to me. If I block their girlfriend, they come for me. If I block their friend, they come for me. And the more I block them, the more they just come with worse and worse hate. So then I have to keep blocking them. And I know what's going to happen now. I sit there and I look for the negativity as if, like, I'm searching for it, as if I want it to be negative, but I don't. And then when I see it, I can't help but feel absolutely rubbish. And I know that there's so much going on in the world at the moment, and it's like, why am I worrying about this? Like, there's people dying, but people are telling me to die. And going, like, and it annoys me when people are like, it's just words, don't let it affect you, but these words become actions. Like, every action creates a reaction, and these people, yeah, okay, my reaction is this, but I'm absolutely crumbling. I'm like a shell of who I used to be. I never used to be like this. Never. I was so positive and happy, and even if something negative would happen, I'd speak about it, I'd cry about it, and I'd be fine, but here we go. She's got her own channel. She's just sending me hate. And I don't want to read it. I don't want to read it. But you can't help but want to read it. Spencer says he's just going to take it all off from me. Because if I'm having a detox and still going on it, then that's not really a detox, is it? Every time I even pick up a camera, pick up a laptop, pick up a phone, go outside, go for a walk, go to the shops, I feel like I'm going to have a panic attack or an anxiety attack or... My parents are going through this, my family's going through this, my friends are going through it, like... Do you think my parents want to see all this? And I know when I'm editing this video back, I'm going to hate myself even more. Because I'm going to watch the video and be like, I hate you. I hate you. Come on. I thought I'd just get my husband on here because I just wanted to kind of document and ask you questions about how it's affecting you and us, the mm-hmm. hate that I've been receiving and like... what's been happening and stuff like that, just your perspective kind of thing.
Well, yeah, obviously first and foremost it's horrible to see that my wife is getting hate and how it affects her and how she's feeling down all the time, and it's just not really nice. So that's been the worst bit about it for us. And I kind of feel like you're a bit on edge at the moment, so living around you being on edge is it's sad,
not nice.
And it's just like just sort of making sure that you don't have any panic attacks and stuff like that, because obviously that's really bad. So just making sure that preventing that from happening, or if you're going through it, that I make sure I'm there for you. Make sure you're not on your phone so much, because obviously you even though there's so much positive comments, a negative comment will just obviously be really detrimental to sort of your progression to hopefully getting back to being better again. Your mood is totally different. Like, it's a lot more depressive, and you're you know, you're down and just not happy within yourself.
I just wanted to come on here because I just feel so overwhelmed and emotional at the moment, and I feel like I'm so embarrassed putting this video up because I'm showing like such a vulnerable, horrible side, which I really don't want to show, but this has been my reality for a while. And I don't know, I know that the people who don't like me are going to watch this and probably love it. They're probably going to love it. They're probably going to sit there and take screenshots of it and send it to me and tell me that I look ugly when I cry and I've got fake eye makeup around my eyes. I feel broken. That's what I feel. I feel broken. I feel like I always said I'd never let people get me down and let hate affect me, and it's so easy to think that you wouldn't.
But it's like, there is only so much someone can physically keep being told about their body, their face, their personality, the way they say hello on their channel. Like, I just want to get back to being me. I want to stop. I haven't been out of the house properly for a week. I haven't been for a walk. I hate myself for allowing them to win. I just want to be me again. God, I feel so on edge and anxious all the time. And I know I'm probably not great for Spencer to live around because I'm just not myself. And I know he doesn't mind, but I just feel panicky, shaky all the time. I feel insecure all the time. I feel ugly, hideous. I hate everything about myself at the moment. It's really horrible to say that you hate yourself. So I've got to be myself for the rest of my life.